To last year's budget standoff, lawmakers have to agree on further cuts this summer or automatic cuts take place. One of the big departments that's going to be cut is defense. So with no deal in sight, defense contractors are warning they may send advance layoff notices to their employees, which would arrive just days before the November election, prompting the Labor Department to step in. Congressman Bob McKeon is the chair of the House Armed Services Committee, and he's my guest this morning. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Gretchen.
All right. So the way in which this mandate reads, the WARN Act requires most employees with 100 or more workers to give 60 days notice of plant closings or mass layoffs, labor cutbacks affecting 500 or more workers. So it sounds pretty clear that sequestration would, this would come into play, right?
It will. What people need to understand is we've cut, as you said, heavily in the Defense Department. Half of the cuts that we have voted so far in the last year to save off of our deficit have come out of defense, which, and Defense Department only accounts for about 17% of the saving of the defense spending, of the national spending. And on top of that, kicking in next January is sequestration, which are automatic cuts across the board, of another $500-600 billion out of defense.
Right. So that was the poison pill when the super committee could not come up with a resolution for our national deficit. And that was
right.
A way in which people thought that members of Congress would come to some sort of resolution because they wouldn't want that poison pill, but they didn't. Now the Labor Department, in a way, do you think it's political that they do not want these pink slips to go out on November 2nd or 3rd, right before the election?
You know, we've been waiting for some kind of guidance for months from the administration, and it's we haven't been able to get it from OMB. We haven't been able to get it from the Defense Department. And yesterday, or the day before, the Labor Department kicks in and says, don't send out those notices. Those notices are required by law.
Right.
And here we've got a department of the federal government saying, don't send them out.
Right. Here's part of that statement. They said to employees of federal contractors, including in the defense industry, is not required 60 days in advance of January 2nd, 2013, and would be inappropriate given the lack of certainty about how the budget cuts will be implemented and the possibility that the sequester will be avoided before January. So let me ask you this, Congressman. Will the sequester be avoided? What can Congress do? And more importantly, what can the president do to stop this?
The House has already acted. We passed a bill that pays for the first year of sequestration, which would move the debate back out of a politically charged atmosphere of the election. Mm. The Senate hasn't acted. The President hasn't provided any leadership. He is the Commander-in-Chief. It's inconceivable to me that the Commander-in-Chief, the one that should have the most interest of the defense of this nation at heart, has not provided any leadership. He could call Harry Reid today, and Harry would get a vote in the Senate, and then we could do what the Constitution says, and each body could that has passed a bill comes together in a conference committee and resolves the differences, mm-hmm. and sends it to the president to sign, and we could take care of it tomorrow. Mm-hmm. But the president is AWOL on this issue. He's just not providing any leadership.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for the explanation. It's all up to the Senate right now, and possibly the president putting a little pressure on Harry Reid. Congressman Buck McKeon from California, thanks for your time bright and early this morning.
Thank you.